dig up a past I swore. Stay buried.
You will always be a monster.
Ares!
I have nothing more to hide.
The ghost of Sparta had been born.
The Blade of Olympus is not as powerful as you think. Zeus created the Blade of Olympus for one purpose, to defeat the Titans in the Great Titan War. But the Blade of Olympus did no such thing. The Blade of Olympus did not kill a single Titan in the Great Titan War, for Kratos snatched the Titans before the wave from the Blade of Olympus reached them. And this begs the question, is that why Zeus asked Kratos to drain his powers into the weapon? What were Zeus's true intentions? Is the Blade of Olympus as strong as we were led to believe? If so, is it because Zeus created such a formidable weapon, or is it because Kratos drained his powers into it, or both? Is Zeus as strong as we thought? Is he even as clever as we thought? I mean, he did trick Kratos into draining his powers into the weapon, but he wasn't very manipulative or intelligent with how he went about it, at least not as much as Odin would have been. The question we all should be asking really is, are the Norse gods stronger than the Greek ones, or vice versa? Who would win in a battle, the Greeks versus the Norse? Which pantheon is going to prove more difficult for Kratos to conquer? Well, let's see. Odin created not only this world but six others. He created man and woman and gave them life. He has knowledge imparted to him by drinking from the well of knowledge. He has hung from the world tree while pierced by his own spear in order to learn the wisdom that would give him power in the nine worlds. And to complete his omniscience, he forced the spirit of Volga to give him knowledge of past and future. And he has Hugin and Munin, who are the living embodiment of thought and memory, allowing him to know everything everyone else does. I can't recall Zeus having any feats to compare to this, other than maybe some of the eternal punishments he inflicted, although Odin has a few of these as well. Zeus certainly doesn't possess much in the way of intelligence, as he regularly gets duped by gods and mortals. He did once state that if all the other gods took hold of a rope and he held the other end, they could not topple him. Nice, he's got strength. Very comparable to things Thor has done in Norse myth, and Thor has stated he would never dream of attempting to overthrow his father because Odin was infinitely more powerful. The Norse gods are much stronger than the Greek gods, and not because they are weaker. The Greek gods are not weaker, not a chance, but they are nowhere near as clever as the Norse gods are. The Norse gods may appear to be dumb, they may appear to lack intelligence, and this is mainly because we saw Magni and Modi fight Kratos and how dumb they were, but that's not the case. They are clever, especially Odin, but they're selfish. That's what makes them appear stupid. Their selfishness is what makes them appear to be dumb. This was something that the Greek gods lacked. The Greek gods were not selfish. They were powerful and they were kind before Kratos released fear, the power of fear and hope from Pandora's box. And this is evident in God of War 1, when Zeus helped Kratos, Poseidon, Hades, Aphrodite, even Artemis. Even Artemis helped Kratos out. The only other intelligent being I would consider to be as smart as Odin would be Athena. But even then, I don't know. I would love to see Athena have a major role in the new God of War Ragnarok. It would be absolutely insane if she was like sort of the force behind everything that happens. But yeah, I guess we're just gonna have to find out and see. If you guys like this video, please do leave a like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell for more content like this. And I'll see you in the next one.